Hello everybody. The subjects of today's episode are two men who took different paths to becoming Dunedin-based artists. The first, John Charles Veitch, was born in Stirling in Scotland in 1854. His father was a soldier in the Black Watch Regiment, and the family moved around a bit, stationed in various garrison towns in Scotland and England. Eventually he studied draftsmanship at the Glasgow School of Art, where he also showed some talent as a painter. But in 1874, when he was about 21, he became attracted to the idea of emigrating to New Zealand. It's said that his father wasn't keen for him to leave. He went anyway, working his passage on the ship Invercargill to get there. He spent the next 3 years roughing it in New Zealand, mostly in North Otago, before making a brief visit back to the old country. When he returned to New Zealand, he landed a job as a set painter in Christchurch theatres. That job didn't pan out long term, so he went back to working in the back blocks. But in 1879, a horse fell on him, leaving him lame for the rest of his life. Over the next few years, the local newspapers give us a few glimpses of Veitch taking up pencil and brush. They tell of him creating a wide variety of works, local landscapes, caricatures, paintings of animals, and so on. In 1886, he produced a watercolour of Auckland, which can today be found amongst the collections of the Auckland Art Gallery. He based the work on an old print of the city's waterfront in 1852, which you can see here. Veitch then moved to Australia and spent several years furthering his career there. But he later returned to spend time in New Zealand. He's reported to have opened a gallery in Dunedin in 1895. He occasionally appears as an artist in Dunedin post office directories of the 1900s, 1910s, and 1920s. In 1912, he produced a large view of Mount Cook and the Hooker Valley for an art union lottery. The painting was said to be highly regarded by his fellow Dunedin artists, but he also grew a reputation for painting Italian scenes as well as New Zealand ones. Now, this episode of Talking Pictures was originally just going to be about Veitch, but we only have two of his paintings in the museum, this one and the Highland Cattle one. So with only two pictures to talk about, it was looking like it might be a short episode until I discovered a connection with another artist represented in our collection. John Charles Veitch's parents and some of his younger siblings came to live in Dunedin in the 1880s. His father passed away here in 1892 and his mother in 1906. When he also passed away here in 1933, John Charles Veitch was buried with his parents in the Northern Cemetery. And an unmarried sister, Amelia, who passed away in Dunedin in 1923, is buried at the Anderson's Bay Cemetery. But John Charles Veitch had another sister who lived in Dunedin for a time. Her name was Elspeth, and in 1901 she married Albert Ernest Bollard, son of Auckland politician John Bollard, and brother of artist William Allen Bollard. In 1903, Allen Bollard was declared an alcoholic and sent from Auckland for treatment at the Arakanui Home for Inebriates near Dunedin. 10 months later he was released. Rather than return to Auckland, he chose to settle in Dunedin, where his and Veitch's paths crossed. Both would exhibit with the Otago Art Society. While Veitch displayed The Storm Cloud at the Otago Art Society in 1908, Bollard exhibited a view of the Takatimu Mountains from the Waiau River in Southland. This view of Te Waiwai Bay, dated 1908, is probably from the same series. This one is much later and closer to home. It's titled Waihola from the Park Hill and is dated 1938. And there you have it, two of a kind, interconnected yet different artists represented in the museum's collection in small measure. Just enough for this episode. See you next time, and thanks for watching.